We've caught up with Halyna Yanchenko a few times over the last couple of years. She's a mother and member of Ukraine's parliament. She joins me live from Kiev. Thanks for joining us again, Halyna. This latest attack on the city of Lviv is extraordinary because that city is so far to the west in Ukraine. It's close to the Polish border. Isn't that where a lot of Ukrainian people try to escape, you know, so far from the front line? It's thought to be peaceful and a safe haven.
This is true. Lviv is really on the very west of the country, and this is basically in the opposite side from Russia. But for the past 2.5 years after the full-scale invasion, Russia is attacking not only frontline, but also a number of peaceful cities. And usually their victims are not the military centers or any kind of so-called strategic or military goals, but rather the residential houses, as you see on this videos right now. In the last attack on Lviv, a lot of civilians were murdered, including a family which consists of a mother and three daughters. Their father was alive, but you can only imagine what kind of tragedy this man goes through. So this kind of damages became quite a useful picture in Ukraine now. And but what makes me stressful and disappointed is the slow military assistance of some of our allies. For the past months, Ukraine is pleading our Western neighbors, including Poland and some other countries, to actually use their air defense to cover the sky at least over the western part of the country. And there were numerous situations when Russian missiles or Russian drones, which they received from Iran, so-called Shaheds, they were actually exiting Ukraine and flying, for example, over the territory of Poland, but there was no reaction of Poland. So this is something that makes me personally very disappointed. And yep. I believe that the strategy and reaction and general attitude of the Western countries should change. There should be more engagement.
Well, they've got to step up. As you say, that these sort of attacks on residential areas in the west of the country, there's no military target there. There's no military benefit. It's about terrorising the whole of Ukraine and the Ukrainian population. And as you say, Western countries are happy to give Ukraine some sort of support, but it's so limited. It seems like there's not enough commitment from the West and NATO countries to make sure you can win and end this war. They're allowing this stalemate to go on for years.
This is true. And the thing is that, in my opinion, some of the countries are not ready to have more engagement, has more engagement, because they hope that at this point, this is the problem of Ukraine solely, but this is not. Because actually we should recall that Russia is an aggressive country, which have been messing with their neighbors, which has been invading and murdering civilians for the past 30 years. Ukraine is not the first country which became a victim of Russian war of aggression. Before that, it was Georgia, it was Chechnya, it was Moldova, and they actually say that they are ready to invade Poland or some Baltic countries like Lithuania, Latvia, and Estonia. They are threatening the whole Europe. So Russia is a factor of aggression and a factor of risk for this whole region. And therefore, there should be more active participation not only of the countries of the region, but generally of the countries which believe that they belong to the Western civilized club of countries, so to say.
I agree with you. And we need more leadership, as ever. We need more leadership from America, and we'll see what comes out of that, I suppose, after their election. But America needs to lead the way here, and Australia needs to do its bit. Thanks so much for talking to us again, Halyna. I appreciate it.